The future used to be so clear when I was reliving the past. Once I caught up to the moment I had left, that ended. All I've had to go on since then are the plan and the visions. I knew Jack would come to me. I'd seen that. But I didn't know why exactly or how it would end.
There he is.
Visions of the future aren't always clear, but they don't lie.
Speaking of lies, Joyce is saying he's discovered his brother's time machine.
We've spent 17 years looking for it, and he finds it in less than a day?
Does sound unlikely.
It's out there somewhere, and we don't know what his brother managed to tell him.
If he really has located the machine, why would he come here and tell you? Smart Money says he's trying to play you.
Maybe, but the machine is out there. It's in our interest to find out where. And if Jack knows, I have to talk to him.
Dr. Joyce could have provided the answer to that question.
William's attitude and knowledge made him a liability.
Is that angry young man going to cooperate any more than his brother did? You remember Jack as a close friend, but that clouds your judgment. Don't make this personal.
It's not.
But don't forget why we're here tonight. After what happened, our people need reassurance that we're in control. You're the man who could win them over. Let me handle Joyce, so you can concentrate on your speech.
I know what's at stake here, Martin. And here you are.
I had to see the lifestyles of the sick and traitorous up close and personal. And it was such a nice invitation.
How do you want to deal with this, Paul?
I could still try to reach Jack and make him see reason. Or I could let Hatch deal with him so nothing would distract me from leading Monarch.
Up into the past.
Answer me this question, Paul.
And anybody. Make him understand the truth.
The fuck do you mean nobody got a look at the shooter?
But without me there to give the speech, my empire would start to crumble like a house of cards.
I believe that with hope comes miscalculation. And as you and I are aware, Mr. Joyce, with miscalculation can offer. And that leaves me with you, Mr. Joyce.
But my old friend would be a lost cause. Most of my past.
Tonight is a celebration. A celebration in face of darkness. Tonight we celebrate because I promise to you that we are prepared.
Monarch would grow stronger with my presence. The plan would go forward as intended. Martin, I'm afraid you're gonna...
All right.
Jack and I...
Yeah.
I've seen where this leads. I've been to the end of time, and I've escaped 1999, when it all started. I've tried to change things, but by trying, I only made them happen in the first place.
Security was tight at the Monarch Gala. You took quite a risk walking into the lion's den.
If we were gonna kidnap Dr. Amaral, then we needed to do it from the inside.
Beth Wilder. You were quick to trust her.
We had common interests.
Is that all you had?
It's all we needed.
Well, I was starting to think seeing a pretty lady like you is too much to hope for.
Why don't you keep your mouth shut while we get some privacy before we begin? Okay.
How about you get me out of this chair?
And you're gonna need this.
I appreciate it. What's it look like out there?
I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Emerald?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation? Looks like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't going to survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul.
Good luck.
Hey! He's escaping!
Will hurt in the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
Who the hell designs these doors? Okay, I'm gonna have to move faster to get through. Very sci-fi and very monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
Get radar tower up ahead.
He could have warned me about that one, Beth. Okay, how am I getting to that radar tower? Here you go. Let's try this again.
explain the dry dock scene to the public.
Hey, it was just our people there. We can spin it however we want. Call it an accident. Or pin it on Joyce.
Yeah.
Hostile! I got eyes!
Thank God.
Time felt broken here. The timeline of the old cannon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Smart place to aim the cannon, guys.
I've been thinking. Monarch projections say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
he'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutterproof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office, too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I can grab it for you.
Yeah, I heard he took a personal interest in it. Somebody said it's because of the...
Thanks, Beth. I need to get to the radar tower. Okay. Next stop, the radar tower. Beth? I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret. The elevator inside will take you down.
Oh, seriously? What is this, a Bond villain lair?
You have no idea. Just don't fall into the shark tank.
Fuck.
Speech
is streaming. Let's give Monarch the audience they deserve.
Unfortunately, Mr. Serene is preoccupied with as many duties necessary to assure we maintain control over our path forward. And that's what tonight is about. The future. We all knew this day was coming, even if many of you out there aren't sure what it means.
Hey, Beth. I'm headed down into the labs.
Okay. Bit of confusion here at the party. Serene's right-hand man's on stage. It was supposed to be Serene.
Yeah. I think Paul was too busy trying to have a heart-to-heart with me to make it. shit! More frequent.
It was some kind of surveillance drone. Knowing that Monarch had eyes in the sky made me a little uneasy.
Are you sure this can't be traced back to us?
Impossible. I've adjusted the flight controls, so the drone will crash into the villa on your order.
Good. Very good.
What the hell is this? What is that? It's like I'm being drained.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
When Paul visited me in that cell, he said time was a closed loop. Believed the fracture couldn't be fixed. Seeing the scale of that facility made me wonder. Time was ending? What was it all for?
Which way is Amron's office? Oh, hello. might be able to get out from here. This isn't the usual employee route. Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth. That's Amaral's office.
Amaral had tried to warn Paul. The end of time was approaching quickly. Less than 24 hours away.
Mr. Serene believed it would take years to run its course. Admittedly, he was wrong.
The gear Beth wanted was supposed to be in Dr. Amaral's office. I had to get it for her before I left.
That there looks like what Beth wanted. Oh, shit. Amaral's at the park. This stutter won't last. I better find a way out of here and get to the party.
Quite expensive piece of tech you stole.
Bill me. I knew Beth's cover wouldn't last long. Had to get it to her at the party before it was too late. Guns made to operate in a stutter. Paul had clear priorities. Time ends, guns don't. The Monarch combat gear was unwieldy. What I'd taken from Dr. Amaral's office was much lighter, almost like a civilian model.
Garage. Sounds like the way out of this place.
All I had to do was make it through the garage. Seems simple enough.
gonna make my life any easier. There's gotta be a way out of here. Talking about. Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
They say Hash getting shot at was an insider job. I create a window for us. She's looking for you.
Beth, I've got company. I'll see you at the party.
SQ advancing!
Great. That's the last of them.
Exact coordinates for Joyce ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving into intercept.
This is Hash. Guard 5. Just spotted him entering the tunnel system outside the party grounds.
Huh. Again.
I could see the mansion where the gala was. I had to find a way to get there. See the energy field of another Monarch Chronon down. It'd drain my powers. I'd have to find a way to shut it off.
My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tight. Give me a shut that machine off.
Somebody get Serene back here!
that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tight. Maybe you want to shut that machine off.
That Joyce freak's on the loose? Somebody tried to kill Hatch? They gotta lock this down before it gets worse.
Yeah, now I'm talking. I better be careful. Security's tight. Maybe we'll shut that machine off. Won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tight. Maybe you want to shut that machine off.
That Joyce freak's on the loose? Somebody tried to kill Hatch? They gotta lock this down before it gets worse.
Yeah, now I'm talking.
No doubt.
Back here! My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful. Security's tight. Maybe you want to shut that machine off.
That Joyce freak's on the loose? Somebody tried to kill Hatch? They gotta lock this down before it gets worse.
Yeah, now I'm talking.
No doubt. At least that's way above our pay grade.
Joyce is here!
You were headed for the party. What was your plan?
I needed to get to Dr. Amaral before the stutter ended and Monarch found out I was coming.
Should be here somewhere. Need to get to her before the stutter ends.
A traitor fired shots during Mr. Hatch's speech. I assume this was Beth Wilder.
We both know it wasn't. Hatch wanted to send Monarch into a state of disarray. Best way to avoid blame? Look like...
What the?
Easy. Hey! It's okay. It's me.
Look at all this.
It's your style. These people have no idea you shouldn't even have a positive amusement park.
I don't think my cover's gonna last.
Yeah, well, I don't think it would do much good for the next part anyway.
Okay, Dr. Amaral's somewhere inside the mansion. Let's go grab her. Bit of luck, we can be gone before anybody notices.
Okay, lead the way. What's our plan once we grab her?
There's a boat dock right outside the mansion.
Okay, we can make that work. Wrong place at the wrong time, literally.
Jack, Dr. Amaral's in there. We need to get her out before time kicks back. We shouldn't wait. Let's go get Dr. Amaral.
We need your expertise. I'm not asking.
It's collapsing!
Come on, move!
Where's the damn boat?
It's right here.
Okay, go! Get her on the boat, I'll keep you
safe. Come on, Doctor!
Go, hurry up!
You'll never get away with this!
Shit!
Get in!
Joyce from the
you.
You're clear. Go.
I can swing by and...
No. Just go. We went to all this trouble to grab her. Beth.
I got a vision.
My plan was simple. There's a bridge to the mainland. Fight my way through anything Monarch would throw at me and steal a car. Drive it back to the swimming pool.
Just remember, we need your ass alive for the next part.
Not just keep firing!
Yeah, I'll shake it. Beth and Dr. M are all clear, it was time for me to get gone. For that, I needed wheels.
okay? Time to get a ride out of here.
Valet parking.
This thing growing inside me. I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the Cronon syndrome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
Norton, how is it possible they managed to take her?
Paul, is your illness talking? I'm on your side. Easy, you're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir? We've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there.
I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Amaral doesn't. Is the lifeboat even in a viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. She could be one of them.
She isn't.
Are you willing to bet the entire plan on that? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand. How do you want to proceed?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.
Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
She's always been loyal.
The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life.
All right, Amaral. Let's go fix the time machine.
I couldn't simply ignore it, despite everything we had been through.
But she took them away.
If she... the damage could be immeasurable. Sophia's data's always been good. I'll trust her to analyze these figures and make final preparations to activate the lifeboat protocol at once.
Fine. I'll take the laptop to the science department.
No, I think I'll do that myself.
I see.
It's
Sir?
Put people on Mr. Hatch. I want constant eyes on him.
Yes, sir. You got it. We pulled some images from the security cameras. We've identified Joyce's accomplice. She's Beth Wilder, one of our mid-level operatives.
Her. My God, she's been with us all along. She's working with Jack. Where is she now?
Unknown. But we've got a kill team tracking her.
No. She can't be killed. And whatever Mr. Hatch does, I want to know about it. Don't screw this up.